So I'm very happy to introduce my colleague, Mr. Shaukat Ali, who is the senior manager who leads the Aakash logistics team, and Vinu Thomas, his associate. They have a large team of about 12 people, 11 people. And I would like to publicly compliment that team because they handled the collection of 1 lakh tablets from the vendor. They handle the entire logistics of distribution of these 1 lakh tablets to more than 300 remote centers. And thanks to their work, we were able to provide tablets to many of our students and teachers at your places. So let's give them a big hand, first of all. Thank you so much. Now to the problems. Obviously, when you use gadgets like this, there are issues associated with their performance, their technical issues that you face and so on. I have another team which I have set up to solve the technical issues. And after this discussion, I'll be inviting members of that team to help us understand how technical problems associated with the tablets are to be resolved. So this first part of the session, we are not going to talk about the technical problems or broken screens or any such thing. We are only talking about the logistics involved in handling the safekeep of the tablets, the usage of the tablets, the issue of the tablets, the return of the tablets, including the return of damaged tablets, collection of repaired tablets, etc. Exactly how technical problems are to be resolved, we'll discuss it later. Is that all right? Okay. So, first of all, this is one question which Professor Kannan had asked. Are there any remote centers where the tablets are kept in the cupboards? And he was surprised to find that there were a few remote centers where actually the tablets were just kept in the storage and not being used. The objective of the whole project was that the tablets should be extensively used, typically by the final year students and the teachers who guide their projects. So let me tell you the genesis of this whole project once again for your benefit, because not all of you are Aakash project coordinators. In fact, very few of you would be. Most others have only been users of Aakash tablet in some sense or the other. The objective was to get these 1 lakh tablets, procure them as low-cost access cum computing device, and get them lab tested and field tested. We did sample lab testing on some samples from every batch that we received at the CDAC labs in Thiruvananthapuram, and we distributed tablets to these remote centers. We had conducted a training program for teachers and then subsequently for students on Android development, and we had told all our remote centers, please issue these tablets to final year students who are doing their project. We had emphasized that these tablets shall perpetually remain the property of the Government of India, because these are being issued free of cost. They are not being purchased by individuals or students. We have no mandate to sell these, no mandate to collect money for these and issue it. So we had said that these are to be issued like a book bank or a library book is issued. After you finish your work, you are supposed to hand over tablet back to your institution. So these shall remain perpetually the indirect property of the institution, which is the Aakash Project Center, on behalf of IIT Bombay, which is acting on behalf of MHRD. That was the idea. Apart from being used in the final year projects, we had also expected that these tablets should be extensively used by all teachers who participate in the 10,000 teachers training program. And that is because using these tablets, we wanted to conduct our regular quizzes in such large program. Additionally, we wanted to expose the participating teachers as to how such simple Android tablets with an additional facility of making it into a Linux machine could be used subsequently in their own work. I had already mentioned, but I will repeat that the next phase of Aakash activity has started about 6 months ago. The specifications of new Aakash have been worked out. They have been approved by an interministerial committee. DGSND, which does the rate contract activity on behalf of government for all kinds of things, has conducted a RFP process or a tender process. I have invited bids for the next version of Aakash. The mandate is to identify 3 or 4 vendors who can supply Aakash as a pre-stipulated price. So there was a price discovery. The lowest price was discovered. I think it was something like 3,500 rupees or something, whatever. And then all other vendors were asked whether they can match that price. So 5 vendors, I understand, have agreed to match that price. And that these 5 vendors have been technically shortlisted. Now they have submitted their samples to CDAC. CDAC is evaluating those. Our mandate for the remainder of the project is now very simple. We have to ensure that all the applications and content that we have developed so far, not only at IIT Bombay, but at all other places. And I'll speak more about the content development and commonality when the technical team comes here, because they also supervise the management of all common content. As you know, all content and applications are necessarily released in open source to be made available to everyone. So our mandate for the next year will be only limited to ensuring that all these applications and content are properly ported on the next version of Aakash, which will obviously run a higher version of the Android platform. Maybe it is Jelly Beans or whatever, we'll look at that. But there are no more Aakash centers that can be opened now, because all 1 lakh tablets we have got and we have distributed. We have no mandate or no money to purchase any more tablets. However, once the DGSND rate contract is finalized, it will be available on the Indian government website, and any individual or an institution or a university or a government department can place an order and purchase those many Aakash tablets directly from any one of the 4 or 5 vendors. IIT Bombay will have nothing to do with that process. So I hope you take back this message, that in future, any Aakash tablet requirement, etc., etc., has to be met individually by that institution or by their university or by a government department in that area or whatever it is. IIT Bombay will not be involved in any further procurement and therefore any further distribution. Our mandate was related to only the first version of Aakash, or the Aakash 2 as we call it, and that's the end of it. Now, in terms of this, we have distributed the tablets, as I said, to more than 316 remote centers, something. There are some remote centers under T10. I have already mentioned to you that all our Aakash project centers are co-located at the remote centers which conduct the T10KT project. In addition, we also have a few more institutions, but these are 6 IITs which have set up Aakash application project development lab, 6 or 7. But other than that, we do not have a situation where there is some Aakash project center or Aakash center, but which is not a remote center. And that is the reason why whatever I am saying is pertinent to all of you, because you all belong to regular remote center of IIT Bombay. There are other remote centers which have not participated in this particular event, and therefore they are not present here. But as I said, in the last 6 months, we have added more remote centers to our teachers training activity. Not all of them have become Aakash project centers. So the first task is to ensure that all such remote centers are Aakash project centers. And as I mentioned, those 6 or 8 people amongst us who do not have an Aakash center currently are requested to meet Mr. Shaukat and Mr. Vinu. I'll request them to be there sharp at 2 o'clock in the logistics office. I again repeat, the Aakash logistics office is located on the ground floor of the old CSE department. So those who go into the maths department for their labs, and if they have coordinators who belong to this category of wanting to become Aakash project center, they should go and meet them. My team will tell you exactly the kind of documents that are required to be submitted. If you have some sample copies, you can get them Xerox. What the remote center or the Aakash center has to stipulate, how they have to appoint people and so on. It is there on the web anyway, but they will show you what it is. And make sure that after going back, your principal or director of the institution gets the necessary formality done so that Aakash tablets can be sent to those centers. Now, unfortunately, in the earlier remote centers, we have sent a much larger number of Aakash tablets, because at that time we had estimated that these many tablets we can give. Roughly they are about 240 or such tablets. So there are variations depending upon the activity in the remote centers, but of that magnitude. We will not be able to do that for the remaining new centers which are coming up. But what we want to ensure is that at least 50 tablets are sent to every remote center, every new Aakash center, so that at least when the teacher participants come for the T10KT program, they will be able to use them. And additionally, even 50 tablets are good enough to kickstart any final year project activities built around Aakash. So that is the objective. Now, when the tablets are sent, there are some technical problems and there are some physical problems that get associated with these tablets. First and foremost, a tablet is lost. And a student reports that a tablet is lost. So can I have a feedback from people like you who are at least familiar with this? How do you handle this situation? Buy a new one and replace it. Okay, that's a good suggestion. Yeah.
We have taken an undertaking. If it is lost, they are supposed to pay the cost of the tablet.
Yes. Okay. So let me just limit ourselves to these two answers. I like the first answer better, and I'll tell you why. And I'll also tell you the genesis of our acceptance of the second answer. Incidentally, today, what is required officially and formally is that if a tablet is lost, the concerned Aakash Project Center must send a demand draft of 2,263 rupees to IIT Bombay. Do you know where this number comes from? This is the price we have paid after long negotiations with the vendor. As far as the government auditors of central government are concerned, if there is a loss, there is a loss of rupees 2,263 to Government of India. If that loss is made up, the auditors are happy. It was from that limited perspective that we had agreed to do what our friend said here. But please appreciate the following possibility. I am a student at your college. For 2,263 rupees, I am unlikely to get a tablet of this kind. I simply declare I have lost the tablet and pay
2,263. This case,
the FIR that the tablet is lost. Yes. So, all the what he mentioned correctly, what we do is, we ask the student to prove that the tablet is actually lost. Now, in case of any such loss, what is the standard legal method? We say, launch an FIR in the nearest police station and submit a copy of that FIR. At least on paper, that proves that the tablet is lost. Now, this process is okay as far as audit is concerned. But please remember, if I'm a coordinator at my college, and if I had planned certain activities for the next year's final year students, then I'm short of one tablet now. Or I'm short of five tablets if five are lost. What our friend there suggested is a much better alternative. That they should be asked to procure a tablet and substitute it in your stock so that that can be used. There are only two problems with this. One problem is legal problem. At our end, because you are supposed to hold all the tablets on behalf of the Government of India, you will have to specify that now you hold one tablet which is different from Aakash, physically. Okay. Technically, it makes a lot of sense because you have a usable material. But the second thing is, who guarantees that all the software will work on it? For example, the Linux image will 99.9% will not work on any other tablet directly unless you redo the device drivers or something like that. So that's a problem. In any case, this issue will be there only for the next 2 or 3 months. We believe that once the rate contract is announced, people both individually and in groups will purchase the next version of Aakash. So that should not be a matter of great concern to us. So I'll appreciate what he said, and that is logically the best thing to do. We will continue to do what we are doing at present. Namely, anybody loses the tablet must do the FIR, must submit 2,263 rupees and give it to us. We had also suggested that 5,000 rupees should be charged to people. Now, there is a lot of discussion here. Within our own groups, people feel that 5,000 rupees will be a good what should I say, incentive for people not to lose or something like that. But legally and technically, we could not find any justification for these 5,000 rupees. I mean, how do you collect 5,000 rupees for something for which you have paid only 2,263 rupees? So while we announce that there will be a 5,000 rupees penalty that is to be collected from people, we will continue to go by these 2,263 rupees things for the existing stock. However, please make sure that the existing stock is well utilized. Once the warranty ends, that is on 30th May, the warranty for all these tablets is ending. Please note that many of these were received even before the 1 year from the this May to the previous May, and we had distributed them earlier. So warranty should have ended there. But we have caught the vendor because of a declaration that he had given that the warranty will start after the CDAC gives the sample test report, and that we got in May, and therefore we are holding for that warrant. After the warranty ends, there is absolutely no way we can handle any kind of repairs or any kind of thing with those tablets. Okay. Now, so that we will discuss when the technical discussion starts. But is there any question or query? So I guess there is no more logistics question. Well, thank you.